el grito de 5 de mayo, papá. Asústame.
Saludos, Rock. Happy 5 de mayo to you.
Happy 5 de mayo. Feliz 5 de mayo para toda la raza que nos acompaña hoy esta tarde aquí en la, nuestro programa y plataforma en el YouTube.
Ay, beso.
Hasta digo YouTube como si no sé inglés.
I know.
PVT. PBT. PBT la chingada de aquí. No, no, no sé.
No te aproveches.
Professional Valley Talk, papá, the Rock and Chaz Show. Sústame one time. 2021 live number 48. We're almost at 50, raza. We're almost at 50. And 51, there's going to be a major change. All right, in one of our segments, okay? All right, so no so se asusten.
The suspense builds. What is going to happen in episode 51?
Big time, bro. Se va a poner pesada. La cosa va a ser algo que va a ser mind-boggling.
Ay, verdad.
El hocico, right? And this is brought to you by Dr. T's Primary Care for Men. Órale. IV vitamin infusion therapy, testosterone, COVID test, sermorelin. Thursday, it's for women. Call 956-441-2188. If you're feeling like mini mascarita sagrada and you want to feel like el spawn, you need to go to Dr. T's Primary Care. Comienzas de luchador chiquito y sales luchador grande, a madre y rudo y la chingada, ¿no? Fácil, le das una buena revolteada a la esposa, a la mujer. Llegas a la casa y le das un flying lip lock y backward flip y la chingada, todo se jale.
You know, what did I say last week? You go from limp to blimp.
Yeah, eso. So ask them about the Trimix. Eso es cuando te inyectas en el lado de la...
En el mofle.
Ajá, no, en el torpedo.
Ahí es.
Y de volar el submarine. Se hace el torpedo, se hace un submarine.
And carna. Then your mofle starts hulking up.
Yeah. And you know what the submarine is full of, right? Don't say it, okay? Don't say it. Dr. T's Primary Care for Men. Call him at 956-441-2188. Vámonos, Recio. No, hombre, está con madre la rolita esta. Does anybody know the name of this? This mariachi song? Let's see if you know it. A ver si la saben, porque no muchos la saben.
Let's see it in the comments.
Órale. Make sure to like, subscribe, and share, okay? Like, subscribe, and share. Ya tenemos 9 thumbs up, y tenemos un thumbs down, y todavía ni ven a Spawn.
Already?
Todavía ni ven a Spawn. Ahorita que miren a Spawn, todos los haters que no lo quieren porque es bien rudo el vato. De repente se van a venir en chingas con nosotros. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the classic t-shirt and masks segment today. And it's brought to you by Rhodey's Country Fried Chicken. The best fried chicken in Texas. Texas born, Texas raised. 35 years of service to their community. 35 años de servicio a la comunidad. Man, that's about as many years as Spawn has been around, no, Spawn?
Yo creo que sí.
Ay, por ahí. The best gizzards, the best tenders, and the best chicken in Texas. Visit them 1910 El Indio Highway, Eagle Pass, Texas. And Eagle Pass, yes, 78852 es el zip code, si lo van a poner en el GPS. Or call them at 830-773-9189. They have curbside service, delivery by DoorDash. El Spawn se puede comer 2 family orders de ahí.
Spawn gets the gizzards, and then he puts them in his enemy's face.
Uh-huh. Ese es, puede ser uno de los final, ¿cómo se dice? The closing move of the match.
Finishing move.
The finishing move. Yeah.
The gizzard of death.
Yeah.
Take that. I thought you guys were wrestling fans.
Yeah. Yeah.
By the way, we wear masks all the time. Yeah. It's not even Cosico de Mayo.
Hey. ¿Ya la traen puesta?
Wasn't there this wrestler that he had the chicken wing? Bob Backlund.
Bob Backlund did the cross-faced chicken wing.
Yeah, the chicken wing.
And that's, you know, endorsed by Rhodey's
Country Fried Chicken. Yeah. Yeah. And we've got Rally. What's going on, Rally? I love that mask.
Thank you. It is show it off.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
This is Phoenix, right?
Yeah. Talk right into. Can you talk into your mic?
I'm sorry. Yes.
There you go, Phoenix.
So I just wanted to show the back. Also, it's really, really neat.
Oye, mira.
Right.
Qué bárbaro.
Asústame.
Puro role playing a la noche, cállate la boca.
Oh my.
Yeah, Rock's finishing maneuver. The impaler.
The pretzel lock.
The pretzel lock.
No. Hey, because I go to Dr. T's. If I wouldn't go to Dr. T's, it would be the sleeper hold, right?
Oh my goodness. Oh my God.
But because of Dr. T's, it's the figure five. Yeah. There's another figure.
The tripodic maneuver.
El
hocico rock. All right. Delicious. She's got, your shirt, babe? What was your shirt?
Oh, yes, I forgot. It's the greatest of all time, Muhammad Ali.
The greatest.
Yeah.
What did I say?
Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. Yeah. Ooh. Muhammad Ali.
Yes, the GOAT.
And now we've got Felicia.
Yes.
La fish.
Wow, man, look at that.
I can't laugh. My mouth is like, this is too tight. I need to loosen this up a little bit. I'm actually Mil Mascaras.
No.
Did I mess something up?
Yes, you did. It's 100 caras.
100 caras.
There you go.
They're going to kick me out. But 100 caras.
The fish was never good at math, so.
I was never good at math or Spanish, so there you go. But tonight I'm La Fish.
I love it.
It is beautiful.
It's super cute.
Thank you.
The fins.
She actually put that together, right? You put it together?
Yeah.
What did you do? Walk us through that. What did you do?
I use my Cricut. My Cricut.
Pura cola loca.
But I put little fins on it to
turn to the side so we can see the
your gills.
I love that. That's awesome.
Check out those sexy gills. No,
no. The little scales.
Yeah.
You can see everything.
And awesome. Did you bring a classic t-shirt too?
I didn't. I just wore a plain black one because I wanted my mask to stand up.
Oh, okay. That's
there
cool.
you go. That's good.
All right. Now we've got Chaz over here. What's going on, Chaz? What do you got?
Well, check this out. Legendary luchador Atlantis. And if you check out the side of the mask, it's got the little fishes. So Fish and I might form a tag team.
Fish. Mm-hmm.
Fish.
An intergender tag team.
Right. Yes. The aquatic version.
Co-ed, or what is it called?
Co-ed. There you go.
Yeah.
And then my shirt is from Pulp Fiction. It's the Big Kahuna Burger, brother.
Yay.
And their finishing move is the ultimate splash.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's what I've got on today, brother.
Dude, you got the head for a wrestler in a mask, dude. You
Thank
do,
you, brother.
Man.
Yeah, you do. I got the profile.
Yeah, look to
Styling
the side.
Styling and profiling.
Look to the side. You know what, Chuck?
Está temblando el vato
ya. Oh, this guy looks like a real wrestler.
You do,
Thanks
you
to do. Dr. T's.
Woo!
Yeah.
What do you have?
Yo soy Volador Jr. Oh!
Yeah. I like the hair.
Yeah, it's so outrageous.
Look at the wall.
Lo que el que me gustaba era el gato volador. El gato volador. Remember that one?
Yeah.
And it was a cat, like a flying cat.
Mm-hmm. There was actually a wrestler called El Gato Volador.
I know, that's why. That's where I saw him at one of your shows, man.
That's right.
El Gato Volador. El Gato Volador. The song.
And your shirt?
My shirt is a classic Venomous. I think this was like the first Venomous shirt they've ever made. And they only had one size left, and I took it, and it fit me a little big, but now it fits me perfect. I wonder why. It's got to be Dr. T's, baby. It's got to be Dr. T's. Oh.
Shout out to the Venomous Brothers, Ray Phoenix, Snake Savage. Jax Phoenix. I'm thinking of the wrestler.
Yeah.
And ladies and gentlemen, pues al que más esperaban, ya llegó el más grande rudo en el mundo de la lucha libre y uno que ha destrozado muchos mascarados y luchadores en su carrera de lucha libre, el Spawn.
Thank you guys, thank you.
Yeah.
¿Qué pasó, Spawn?
Thank you, Rock, for having me over. Thank you guys for this invitation.
Thank you.
It's a privilege being on your show. And we're actually, you know, I mean, I thank you for inviting
pues
me.
Pues es todo, carnal. Nomás pórtate bien y nada te pasa, ¿me
pues
entiendes?
Te traigo un regalito, Rock.
¿Qué me traíste?
Porque siempre me has caído bien gacho, como oh, quiera.
A ver, ¿qué traes?
Pinche payaso de rancho. Mira, oh, te traje tortillas para que tragues,
oh,
perro.
Oh, ¿qué onda?
¡Ey! Para que te acuerdes. Para que te acuerdes cómo te dejé.
¿Vienes de la Michoacán o qué?
Tengo patrocinadores de las tortillas, perro. Ten, te hacen más falta a ti ahorita que cenes a la noche. Para ver si tu mujer te hace tortillas. I don't think your woman's gonna make you homemade tortillas, bro. Don't start with your shit, Rock. Don't start with your shit.
I'm gonna say, no. Bring it up.
Stop it.
I'm gonna give you a referral.
Siéntate, sit down, bro, please, sit down.
Nomás porque hay mujeres aquí, Span, si no te partiera la madre ahorita. No,
hombre, me hace los mandados, hombre.
Pinche tortillero.
I'm already out of breath. We haven't even done anything.
Shit. Oh
my. Sabes muy bien, Span, que cuando luchamos nosotros en aquellos tiempos, fue uno de los más, ¿cómo se dice?
Hyped.
It's been the most, probably, an audience the RGB has ever had. It was back in 2009.
A las 2 de la tarde, en un domingo.
It was at 2 p.m. at the probably one of the best venues the Valley has ever had for Norteño Tejano, which was Tejano Saloon.
Yeah.
Many years ago.
Estaba toda madre el pedo back then, ¿no?
That's right.
You know, a lot of people don't know, like, back in the day, Jerry Lawler was fighting Andy Kaufman, but here in the Valley, we had
Spawn
Rock
versus El Rock.
Spawn versus are the Valley's version of Lawler and Kaufman.
Yo hablé con el Spawn. El Spawn, lo que pasó, ladies and gentlemen, yo estaba en el radio y estaba trabajando en la mañana con Raymond Horta, Plutarco, el Chief y Belén. Y el Spawn le hablaba a Hugo de la Cruz en la tarde, a las 4 de la tarde, y comenzó a hablar muy mal de mí. Y Hugo de la Cruz lo estaba poniendo al aire. Y pues yo me di cuenta y pues el programa de Hugo estaba grabado. Yo cortaba las partes donde editaba las partes donde estaba hablando el Spawn. Y lo ponía en la mañana, y ahí es donde se hizo el borlote ese pedo, ¿entiendes?
Es un desmadre, Rock. Yeah. ¿Qué pasó?
Y de ahí, en uno de los de las tardes, el Spawn le habla a Hugo y le dice que la mamá de Rock and Roll James vendía cosas en la pulga.
Vendía, ¿entiendes?, tamales y nopales y frijoles ahí en la pulga.
Sí.
Which was an insult because she sold more than that.
Yeah.
She had a whole gallery.
Y de ahí lo puse yo en la mañana. Lo puse yo en la mañana y comencé a decir, oye, gato, ya ese jale se pasó la raya, carnal. A la jefa no la
¿y
metes
qué vas
en
a hacer?
Este pedo.
I'm here. What are you going to do about it?
Ese jale no se, you know.
What are you going to do about it? I'm here. I'm here, bro.
No, we already took care of that business, man.
Don't be laughing in this show. I'm for real, bro.
No, yo también, carnal.
I'm for real.
Yo también.
No vengo solo, bro.
Pues yo tampoco. Aquí está mi pitbull, carnal.
Para el pitbull.
Sí.
¿El que tan sigue de tío que el jazz o qué?
Este carnal está aquí.
También tiene cara de pitbull.
Este carnal está aquí.
Hey, and I got the muscles of a pitbull, brother.
Este vato está aquí parte mouth to mouth resuscitation cuando está navegado, carnal, con el ataque de corazón que te va a pegar.
You had to bring somebody with you to be on your side, Rock. Yo vine solo, carnal. I'm by myself.
No, that's not true. He's wearing a Swatch. That's his backup. Any wrestler that wears a 1985 Swatch, that's a dangerous man. Because anybody knows that a Swatch is the most...
Swatch.
I know. When everybody, you know, when you think of Ric Flair, Rolex, Spawn, Swatch.
Yeah.
They go hand in hand, brother.
Sí, wow.
Pinche reloj femenino que tiene este vato. No, hombre, cállate la boca. Shut up.
Válgame, se me están amontonando, qué chingados.
Simón,
you guys are partying up.
Oye, that's right, brother.
Amontonando.
Ahorita invito, invito a mi clica también, bro. ¿Tú ya sé dónde está el estudio? Todos saben.
Tú debes de saber.
Do they also wear watches?
Tú debes de saber de montoneros.
Montoneros, Rock. Ah, nunca, jamás. Yo nunca soy montonero.
Ah, no.
Yo solito.
Ah, no.
Solito puedo.
Yeah, because he weighs enough for two men.
Oh,
what's the matter?
No,
I brought up your weight?
Oye.
Only because you're a wrestler? You're supposed to be in shape?
Hey, bro. It's between Rock and I, but if you want a piece of it, well, you know, I'll get you some shit too.
No, that's fine. I'll just bring a pizza and you'll pass out.
Oh, so you're talking shit too.
Yeah, do you ever do cardio? I mean, you're supposed to be a wrestler.
Bro, I've been retired already for so many years.
Ah, okay. I didn't know that you were drinking in short.
Pero déjame decirte
algo. No, 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 it's okay. No, 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 it's all right.
Hey, bro.
It's me.
No, ando solo, bro.
No, si
se, se está armando el pedo en grande, Rock.
No, aquí, no, no, no te voy a decir ahorita. Y está diciendo,
no quiero que se vayan a meter ustedes, no. ¿Eh?
Oh,
oh my God.
Well, I don't know about that.
I don't want your wife to be changing your pamper, Rock, right now to get beat your ass.
¿Qué peppers? Si tú eres el que anda con peppers, cabrón, qué pinche onda. Pinche depends. Oye, mira. Depends. Yo tengo.
Respétalos a tus.
Seniors.
Mira,
tus
lo
seniors.
Único que te voy a pedir es para que no vengas aquí a mi estudio echando mentiras, carnal. No andes mintiendo, no andes echando mentiras. Tú eres una bola de montoneros, ese es lo que tienes tú y tu clica, son montoneros.
¿Clica?
Sí, la clica.
Toda tu clica, tus bikers, tus amigos, todos. No, la clica tuya. Puros cliqueros baratos.
La clica de tus ruditos chingados que llevas a todos los eventos para brincarle a pobre gente cuando no están viendo.
Why are you guys trembling? You guys are tan temblando de pinche miedo.
No, de coraje, carnal.
Tú y tu mayate que está enseguida de ti.
Mira, yo...
What are you girls laughing about, too?
Hey,
they're still laughing at the Swatch comment.
Huh? Oh, my God.
Mira, guacha. Mira, está diciendo Krabby Krab. Te lo sico, Chaz. Te dan la madre.
Oh, hi, Chaz.
Krabby Krab, you're so full of shit. I'm going to find you and beat the shit out of you, Krabby Krab. And I'm not even playing, brother. Krabby Krab, this is for you, motherfucker.
Ahorita te quitan de YouTube.
How much Dr. T's do you got in you today?
I got a lot. And I'm not going to hold back, brother.
Cálmate, bro.
We love you, Krabby Krabs.
Oye, no, mira.
Is Krabby Krab a male or female?
I don't know, but we love him.
Hermaphrodite.
Se va a poner feelings. Oye. Getting back to my damn Montoneros accusation on this guy. Yeah. Don't think that I don't have proof of that. Porque yo traje recibos, carnal.
Oh, shit.
Yo traje recibos de lo montonero que eres.
¿Qué recibos?
Pon el video, babe.
Uh-oh.
Pasó cuando luchamos el 2009, raza. yo estaba cantando el himno nacional de los Estados Unidos y vieron ahí en este programa, en este video que les presentamos, lo chapucero que es el Spawn, porque me dio por atrás con el brazo, ¿verdad? Y de ahí entraron todos sus flonquecillos a brincarme.
Chusma.
Hasta me cortaron con la lámina y hubo mole por donde quiera. Y aparte de eso, ahí estaban mis padres, estaba mi esposa, mi familia. Y todos salieron bien asustados. Tuvieron que tomar agua después de ese match. So, no digas que no eres...
Los tuviste que llevar al hospital. You had to take them to the hospital. That's what happened.
Pero no digas que no eres montonero. What do you call that, bro?
Hey, bro, let me tell you something.
Arrímate al micrófono.
Let me tell you something. No ando solo. Así como dices tú, no ando solo. No ando solo. I'm not by myself, bro.
Fish, you were there that day, right?
I was.
And yeah. What did you start crying?
She was all scared.
I was.
I remember...
But now, I'm not a little girl anymore.
Oh.
And now, I'm not scared.
Uh-oh.
Now, I'm angry.
She's saying very seriously with a fish-looking with mask. Yes.
Yeah. You know, when her gills turn pink.
And I think I'm pretty afraid of her.
Oh, yeah. Just wait.
Look at that face.
Entonces.
Damn. Where are the gills?
We have some pictures of the after results of it was pretty crazy. It was pretty awesome and famous and the thing about it is I could barely get to the back and some wrestlers were trying to carry me to the back while I was absolutely bleeding all over the place, and it was hard to get me into the back room because everybody was crazy, bro.
Could you even see from the blood?
No, dude, I couldn't see from the blood. It was like, that had to be one of the biggest matches in Valley history, no, Spawn?
Yeah, I think so. I think that's been one of the greatest shows there's ever been. You know, I remember back since the 80s when my dad started promoting Lucha Libre here in the Valley. You know, and I don't remember seeing, you know, so much people in that event.
And that early. Pasamos por ahí. Yo llegué ahí.
Chingado, nadie andaba en la iglesia.
No, nadie estaba en la iglesia. Estaba una línea... que iba alrededor del Tejano Saloon a la 1 de la tarde porque abrían las puertas a las 2.
That's correct.
Y nosotros no luchamos hasta como las 5 o 6 de la tarde, bro.
That's right.
Hicieron una feria ahí en el Tejano Saloon, bro.
Pues quién sabe quién hizo la feria porque... I don't remember getting any money from that match.
Oye, y así...
Yo más te quería partir tu madre, es todo lo que quería. Hey, traía ganas, perro.
Spawn, tell the story about the security and the threats and the
you
whole...
You know, I mean, back it was... What was it? 2009? You know, I started getting the threats from people, I guess from his chicleros, you know, all his clica, Raymond Horta and all those little crazy
Los Brunos de Mercedes.
Toda esa gente, los pintores.
Yeah, porque ahí estaban unos camaradas de Mercedes. And the thing about it is they were shocked when it happened. They weren't expecting. That's the beauty of wrestling and lucha libre is when you shock the audience at a moment where they never expected.
I think
what
it was
saw.
The blood that took it to Chica, the next.
I just remember hitting my pocket, man. $1,000 for security that night just for me, man.
Let me tell you, let me ask you one thing. And I don't know, maybe you have an answer for this. But there's been a lot of celebrities that have come and gone through wrestling, WWE, Lucha Libre, and all that. Have any of them, even local or national celebrities, have any of them cut and bled during the match? No, I think I'm probably the only one, bro.
I don't think so.
Well, first of all, you said celebrity, so
yeah, that's
that
true.
Leaves you out.
Te estás mamando solo.
I know. I'm like celebrity.
Ponle casa, ponte casa, güey.
No,
celebrity.
Ponte casa. That's pinche payaso de rancho. ¿Qué lo quieres, cabrón?
Hey,
what are you girls laughing about?
No,
wait.
No,
oh my God.
Acuérdate como te dije, Rock. Eres un payaso de rancho, George López wannabe.
Oye, Spawn.
¿Te acuerdas palabras?
Sí, sí. No, George López no me vale mío. Pero deja tú. ¿A poco ustedes están ahí que yo celebrity, que yo no soy celebrity, la chingada? ¿Quién crees que llenó el Tejano Salón? ¿Tú, carnal?
Papi, ¿tú? Toda la gente viene a verme.
No, hombre, carnal. No fueron a la iglesia ese día porque yo iba a luchar.
You think you're the one that made it happen?
A huevo.
You think so?
A huevo.
You don't even have an audience, bro.
A huevo.
Where's your audience? Aquí nobody's logging in.
Aquí están todos, carnal. Mira.
Our PVTers, where you at?
Yeah.
Where are you guys? Hey, come on, sign up.
They are. They're there.
Es que estás tú en el programa ahora. Nadie quiere verlo ahora, carnal. Chingao. Es que te quedó bien callado. Chinga, me estás arruinando.
Palabras me quedan, cabrón.
Me estás arruinando el programa, Spawn. Chingao. Ya se cayeron los ratings como el NBA.
Like the Oscars.
Like the Oscars. Grammy Award.
Hey, Rock, like your show? Te lo cico,
no, man. That has to be one of the greatest highlights in my life was being a part of that magic, man. And I had never been involved in any type of wrestling, but, you know, we can't tell you everything that happened before or after the show, but the whole idea was to put an amazing show for the fans and the audience, and I think we did a pretty good job that day.
I think
man.
You're okay. I think there was another one better. Mi compadre Armando.
Armando Almazán.
Mi compadre Armando Almazán.
¿Qué hizo él?
El mono de alambre.
Sí, pero el mono de alambre, ¿qué chingada es eso?
Un personaje. It's a, you know, that was his character.
Ah, sí. ¿Y por qué el mono de alambre?
I have no idea. La canción del mono de alambre. Some song called Mono de Alambre.
¿Y dónde está Mando Almazán?
Ahí anda Armando Almazán.
¿Quién está haciendo qué? ¿Dónde está?
Probably doing the same thing you're doing.
Sí, donde yo nunca lo miro.
not in this talk show.
¿Está trabajando en una taquería o qué? ¿Qué está haciendo Armando Almazán?
Un saludo a mi compadre Armando Almazán.
Saludos, Mando.
Does he work at Roadies?
The Roadies, allá ni go past.
He made the tortillas that he brought in.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, I forgot to say that the classic t-shirt segment was brought to you by Roadies. Yeah.
The best fried chicken, no?
Yes, 35 years of service to their community, the best gizzards, best tenders, best chicken in Texas. Visit them 1910 El Indio Highway, Eagle Pass, Texas, 78852. Call them at 830-773-9189. They have curbside service delivery by DoorDash, and they are the sponsors of the hashtag PBT Classic t-shirts and today Classic Mascaras segment, all right?
We'll be in Eagle Pass pretty soon, Lucha Libre allá con el Rock.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we've also got some hashtag PBT Classic tees from the fans. Why don't you do those for us, baby?
Okay. I'll do it. So we have Señor Rudo from Austin, Texas, and he's wearing the Four Horsemen WCW t-shirt with his mascara.
Nice.
Wow, he looks awesome.
Yes, he looks awesome. Bruta. He looks awesome.
Señor Rudo.
Styling and profile.
And a great name, knowing that, you know, he likes...
Lucha.
Yeah.
He's a Rudo.
Dice D. Lara que el man no está jalando en Spawn's taco truck.
That's what
he handled.
Yeah.
So Spawn is the general manager.
Yes, that's the general man. Imagínate un taco truck de Spawn's.
Right.
Bien picoso los tacos.
Why not?
¿Verdad?
Con chingo de chile.
Yeah.
Como te gusta.
Órale. Let me go to the next page. ¿Qué pasó?
Yeah.
Señor Rudo.
Señor Rudo, un saludito para señor.
Where's that guy from, bro?
Austin, Texas.
Austin, Texas.
Tenemos que ir a hacer un show allá en Austin.
A huevo.
Órale. If you got any pictures, send them to us at 956-641-3241, okay? And we've got some t-shirts. Asústame one-time t-shirt. It's $35. You can get them at Cash App. And make sure to put AOT. That is the code for a Asustame One Time t-shirt. And we have small through 4XL. Put the size. And then put your address. If your address doesn't fit, put your cell phone so we can get a hold of you. We have the Telo Cico t-shirt. $35 as well.
Perfect for Mother's Day.
Yep. I mean, come perfect on. For Mother's Day.
With a flower too included or what?
And it's $35. Code is LP because it's on a license plate. And then put the shirt size small through 4XL and the address, if not your cell phone. So now it's time for the Rockin' Chaz Rockin' Poll. Cinco de Mayo. All right. This is brought to you by The Grill on Westgate in Weslaco, Texas. The newest hotspot in Weslaco. Located about 3.5 miles north of the expressway on Westgate Avenue, they got the coldest beer, wine, entertainment. Tomorrow night, Thursday night, is Stephen May. And then on Friday, Happy the Entertainer, and he's going to be here with us as well at 6 o'clock before he goes up there and does the show. And they've also got the BYOB, Bring Your Own Bottle, and they'll get your setups available. Like I said, this weekend, they've got some great entertainment, $3 domestic Miller Ultra and Budweiser. They also got your imported beer, wings, fried mushrooms, mozzarella sticks, pulled pork, sandwiches. The corner of Mile 12 and Westgate is where you find it. For more info, call Mike at 956-373-6682. He'll take care of you. The best little hideout in Texas. And this Friday night, it is Happy the Entertainer.
And he'll be here in the studio, you said, right?
Yeah, he'll be in the studio 6 o'clock. Also, well, it's time for the poll. And the question is, la pregunta, ¿quién es el luchador más popular en la historia de la lucha libre menos el Santo, Mil Máscaras y el Blue Demon? Okay.
That's a tough question.
That's a question for you all. We're going to let Spawn answer this one, and that'll be the... Because he is the expert at this.
He is.
He's the one that told us the masks.
We were, yeah. I just messed it up, yeah.
And as a matter of fact, tiene una caja de máscaras que nos puede enseñar también durante este segmento, pero platícanos cuáles son los luchadores más destacados de la historia de lucha libre menos Mil Máscaras, El Santo y el Blue Demon, Dan.
Fíjate, I think, Rock, there's been a few, you know, a few besides them. Those four are probably the well-known wrestlers.
Historical,
which is Santo, Mil Máscaras, Blue Demon.
Pioneros, pioneers.
So pioneers, those three are, you know, I say que tiene historia el perro aguayo. Probably.
¿Qué es la historia de perro aguayo?
But he doesn't wear a mask, right?
Yeah, I really don't know much of his story. I just know he was a great legend. I never had the honor of meeting him. I met his son. Okay, he passed away a few years back.
Yeah.
I think Tinieblas is also a big legend in Mexico. I did have the privilege of luchando against him in Brownsville, Texas. I don't know, maybe like 15, 16 years ago. Mm-hmm. I wrestled him and his son, Tinieblas and Tinieblas Jr. I think Tinieblas is a big legend. Was a big legend. He was also in a lot of movies with Capulina, Tinieblas Capulina.
Sí, el comedian.
Yeah, the comedian. So... you know, I think, you know, El Santo Blue Demon, you know, now that their sons are wrestling, you know, hell of wrestlers, you know, they're legends now. El Hijo del Santo Blue Demon, those are, you know, pretty popular, you know, wrestlers in the world. But, you know, now, you know, you have newer talent, you know, La Lucha Libre ha cambiado mucho. It's changed from the 80s, from the 70s to right now, you know.
¿Y qué es el cambio que ha pasado?
It's very different.
Como en qué manera?
Like now you see a lot of more high flying stuff,
uh-huh.
Más vuelos y lances. Antes la lucha era pura ras de lona olímpica, you know, mat wrestling.
Yeah. Do you like it more or do you like it less?
I really me acostumbré con la lucha vieja, la lucha nueva. That's one of the reasons why I also retired, because man, you can't keep up with those guys, man, flying and, you know, going. You got to be in the best shape of your life. You got to do that, you know.
They're acrobats.
That's a job for them, you know. It's a full time job for them to do that. So you right now for me, I think one of the greatest wrestlers there is Penta Cero Miedo, Pentagon. You know, I think my respects to that guy. I brought him here a few times. He's wrestling independent in Mexico. He wrestles with a couple of organizations here in what is it, AEW, I believe. He has a contract with him.
He was with Lucha Underground.
Lucha Underground. I think he's been one of the, you know, que ha destacado, you know, la lucha libre. And Estados Unidos ahorita, you know, he's pretty good. He's a pretty good wrestler.
¿Y qué piensa de como Rey Mysterio Jr.?
Rey Mysterio, I mean, he's a legend. He's probably been the one of the biggest legends WWE
to cross over.
Yeah,
no?
He's to cross over. He's always gonna be in behind the, you know, one of those vitrinas, whatever you call it. You know, his mask is always gonna be there. You know, I think he'll retire. I think he left the organization. He came back. But I think he'll retire from WWE.
Mm-hmm. Oye, otra cosa es como, back in the day, in the 80s, era la lucha americana, ¿verdad? American wrestling. And then you had lucha libre. And they never really crossed paths until the 90s when, you know, Vince McMahon decided. And I think WCW did it first.
They brought in Psychosis.
But McMahon also had Pierrot. He did a thing like at the Royal Rumble here in San Antonio.
That's right. That's right. He had Pierrot, Mil Máscaras. WWE had a Hispanic program.
Cibernético also.
Cibernético.
Yeah.
Yeah. He had a big show with many wrestlers. Mascarita Sagrada Octagoncito, which I've brought him before.
I love watching those.
Yeah,
man.
those guys are pretty awesome.
Yeah, yeah. So there's also, like I said, Pierrot, La Parca,
and Pierrot.
Psicosis,
you know,
yeah. All these that went to WCW. They kind of Conan.
Triple A, right? I think he's Triple A independent. You know.
How well did you know Ramses, who was in Nacho Libre?
I knew Ramses very, very well. You know, he went to my house a few times. You know, brought him multiple times to wrestle for me. As you know I'm a promoter as well. So you know, Ramses, we had a very good relationship. You know, a few years ago he lost his life. You know, he had a cardiac arrest, and he passed away. But
I remember when that happened.
Yeah, no, this guy was, he's actually Dr. Wagner's brother, which one time I did a match over at Los Portales in Alton, Dr. Wagner versus Ramses, which was a Silver King. He wrestled under that name with Triple A and stuff like that, Silver King.
Yeah,
good guys, man. Good guy, you know.
Yeah.
Pero ni modo, you know. Así es la vida, you know. Vamos a estar aquí,
Your dad, bro. Your dad was one of the guys that kind of spearheaded all the
my dad,
promotions. Because I remember meeting you when you were a kid, dude. You must have been like,
I was pretty young,
17 or 16, and I was working with a radio station. And we were at some event, and you came and you sat next to me, and you started, you know, because you knew I was into wrestling and stuff, because I talked about it. And you started telling me about, hey, estoy en la lucha, todo esto. And I was like, whatever.
Yeah, like, chinga tu madre, pinche orquito.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, right.
Pero ahora sí te voy a dar tu madre, güey, ya te la he dado, ¿no?
Rocco was like, where are the chicks? Get out of here.
Yeah. I mean, my dad started doing promotion here in the 80s, 83, you know, with other partners. They brought me in Máscara the first time. I mean, he had been here before with Jose Lotario. They would do shows, and I remember my mom talking to me about, you know, they would do shows at the Donna Boys and Girls Club,
yeah,
at the Harlem Gen Casa de Amistad.
It was part of Southwest Championship Wrestling, Blanchards would bring him in because he had Jose Lotario was part of his clique there.
Yeah, so back in the 92, 93, my dad started promoting Lucha Libre here in the Valley, and that's the way, you know, I went in there, you know, I started training for 2 years, and I debuted it.
Who trained you?
I had a couple of guys from Reynosa, you know, very well known from Reynosa that trained me was Vicente. His name was El Hijo de Yuma back then. I had Rey del Camino from Reynosa. I had Black Cougar, my father. I mean, I had multiple trainers, you know, very good wrestlers. There's a lot of good local talent here actually in Reynosa, and because of them, we have good wrestling, local wrestling guys here as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you had it. That was the Rockin' Chaz Rockin' Hole, brought to you by The Grill at Westgate. Don't forget, tomorrow night, Stephen May. And on Friday night, they've got Happy the Entertainer. He'll be here with us, and we'll be talking about the show before he goes out there and does his performance. You might want to call the number so you can find out about, you know, getting the table. 956, let me see here. Where's the number at? Right here, 956-373-6682. And thank you to Spawn for giving us his
wisdom,
professional opinion on who are the best wrestlers or most popular wrestlers besides...
Of all time.
Besides Santos and Blue Demon and Mil Máscaras.
We can go back time. We can go this time.
Yeah. All right. And now we've got the... Rockin' the Chaz's Collectible! Well, and it's brought to you by...
Rock's looking through the papers.
FFA Financial. And our good friend Eddie Ruiz Coronado at FFA Financial wants to give you the most affordable and best life and health insurance coverage with living benefits and cash value. It's important to have yourselves and your loved ones protected from the unexpected. And to learn how to have and build cash value for yourselves and your children when they'll need it. So talk to him. Contact him. Eddie Ruiz Coronado. 956-598-3487 for all your financial needs. Set your free illustration today. Offices in McAllen and Weslaco. Be prepared, folks, because look at what happened last year with COVID. You know, a lot of people lost their jobs. They got furloughed. Their hours were cut. You need to be prepared for things like that. And FFA Financial will do that. Eddie Ruiz Coronado is a professional, and he can also provide for those that are into their children's academic for college. They also help them to have a children academic future account. You want to kick back, have a tax-free retirement account for your future. Eddie can help you with all that. They've got an amazing website. You give them a call, 956-598-3487. 956-598-3487. Eddie Ruiz Coronado for FFA Financial. Give him a call and be prepared financially. Orale. So, Chaz is collectible. What do you guys get?
Este vato tiene juguetes, carnal. Y tiene collectibles.
Los usa en la noche, ¿o qué chingados?
Tú no colectas nada.
Spawn's on fire, brother.
Hijo eso.
You know, this
yeah,
is...
Yeah, I have a couple of collectibles.
Actually, do we want to do Spawn's collectible? I know he brought some.
Well, I don't know. You want to... we could do yours and then...
Okay, we'll do Spawn. I know you brought a bunch of
collectibles. We don't have to do them, bro. Like, we don't have to do them.
No. Ve, carnal, tienes una caja, traíste toda la casa, carnal, chingado.
Pues, chingado, me estás texteando que me traiga todo.
No, pues, yo no quiero que te vayas a sentir o algo, you know? So let's go with Chaz first.
And then we'll do Spawn's collectible.
And then we'll do Spawn's.
I
want to
see his stuff.
All right. So before COVID, I brought this. This is the only collectible that I've actually made. I made this. This is before coronavirus hit. So I was given this business card. And Riley, what's the name on that business card?
Old West Saddle Shop.
That's right. It's the mm-hmm. Old West Saddle Shop. And the name is?
Eloy Chavez.
Mr. Eloy Chavez. Uh-huh. And so he was saying, like, hey, if you want to make a gun holster, come to the saddle shop, and we'll make a badass gun holster. And I have a .357, and I needed a gun holster. So I went to the saddle shop. It's over there in Edinburgh, and it says, you know, saddle shop. And it's actually like you're going back in time because he's got a setup that is really badass. So, you know, you walk in, you see the sign, it says saddle shop, and he's got, you know, he's got chickens, he has horses, because he'll, you know, if you want to learn how to ride a horse, this guy's authentic, he's a badass. And then I saw the inside of his saddle shop, and sure enough, he can make whatever it is that you want made. So we started working on this project, and, you know, right before COVID hit, I was able to finish it. And if anybody's ever interested in, you know, doing leather works for your gun, for your rifle, he even does the, you know, the Pancho Villa bullet holsters. He makes those too. Rock, let's bust out the chimes here.
Chingo.
So he walked me right through this, and we made this in the shop. And yes, Krabby Krab, I have a .357. And there we have hollow point bullets. And Rally, let's go ahead and show the close-up of this bad boy. Mm-hmm. And there is nothing like from Mexico, badass leather. And we finished it, and it came out super badass.
Let's see one of those bullets, dude.
And I do have...
Is that a bullet from your .357?
This is a hollow point. I have a license to carry.
Oh, yeah.
And because you never know what's going on today.
Que no se chiflet spawn.
Que te lo sigo. Trae la pistola de Pancho Villa, ¿no? La de Mario Almada.
So, if anybody's interested, we have that right here in the valley. And you can make whatever badass product that you want.
Para el stock show.
Ahí es.
So there you have it, folks.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. That's Chaz's collectible. And it's brought to you by FFA Financial with Eddie Ruiz Coronado. Give him a call, 956-598-3487. I'll give you the most affordable and best life and health insurance coverage with living benefits, and I'll have you prepared for the rest of your life. Offices in McAllen and Weslaco. Set your free illustration today. And thank you so much for Eddie Ruiz Coronado, our brand new sponsor here on the Rock and Chaz Show. Órale. Y pues el Spawn trajo unas máscaras. But we're going to go with him right after we take this short break with our sponsors. Okay, we'll be right back.
Dr. T's Primary Care for Men wants to remind you that it's time for your annual physical. Call and schedule an appointment today. It's about the body, mind, and emotion. Stop feeling sluggish, having no energy, or being stressed. Even if you have low testosterone, diabetes, high blood pressure, or gained weight, let Dr. T's Primary Care for Men help you increase your energy, stamina, endurance, and quality of life. Start feeling young again. Dr. T's Primary Care for Men is changing the way men's health care is done. Dr. T's Primary Care for Men. Dr. T's Primary Care for Men te recuerda que es tiempo de hacerte tu examen médico anual. Haz tu cita hoy mismo. Es acerca de tu cuerpo, mente y emociones. Deja de sentirte lento, sin energía o estresado. Aún si estás bajo de testosterona, diabetes, alta presión o sobrepeso, deja que Dr. T's Primary Care for Men incremente tu energía, estamina, resistencia y calidad de vida. Comienza a sentirte joven otra vez. Y ahora ofrecemos exámenes rápidos de COVID en ambas ubicaciones.
The best fried chicken in Texas. Rhodey's Country Fried Chicken. Texas born, Texas raised. A chicken joint with 35 years of service to our community. Thanks to our loyal customers and social media followers. Come try the best gizzards in Texas, the best tenders in Texas, and the best chicken in Texas. Call us at 830-773-9189. 830-773-9189. Don't forget, we have curbside service and delivery by DoorDash. Or find us on Facebook, Rhodey's Chicken. R-O-D-E-E-S Chicken. Like us on Facebook. Like us on Facebook.
The best fried chicken in Texas.
Rhodey's Country Fried Chicken. Chicken.
Y regresamos, ladies and gentlemen. Before we go any further, I want to remind everybody that Spawn has, el Spawn tiene unas cuántos eventos. Tiene un evento que va a ser el 22.
Yeah, we're having an event the 22nd of May over in Elton, Texas at Los Portales.
Okay.
You know, we're going to have a great show with some wrestlers from Multimedios from Monterrey that are coming down. Also, big wrestlers like El Dragón, El Impostor. We're going to have a mask versus hair match entre El Símbolo y El Toro Negro. Plus, female wrestlers are going to be in action. It's going to be a great show. I have a poster.
The poster? Yes, the poster.
Yeah, you want to pass the poster so I can put it up?
Here you go, brother.
Mm-hmm. Right there.
Yeah, this is May 22nd at Los Portales. We're also bringing Sexy Dulce, who she just had an MMA fight recently, I think this Saturday. She lost the fight, but, you know, she'll be there. This is the poster for inviting everybody from the RGV to be there.
That's awesome.
Y de ahí al último de la, del mes, el 24, yo creo que es, ¿verdad? Tenemos a con duelo.
It's the 29th.
El 29th.
It's going to be the 29th at the San Juan City Park. Sí. There's going to be a great lineup, you know, Grupo Duelo, Intenso, Control, plus Lucha Libre, which Pirata Morgan, a big Mexican legend, Pirata Morgan, El Hijo del Pirata Morgan, female wrestlers, and plus much more. You know, those are the two main stars. Pirata Morgan, which you fought Rock as well, in San Benito, Texas. I don't know.
Sí, pues estuvo conmigo. Era mi partner. Contra ti.
No, estás equivocado. No te acuerdas de la chinga que te puso. It was me and Pirata. Remember that? Versus you and somebody else. Silverstar from Monterrey.
Sí. Yeah, ustedes estaban chapuceros, bro.
Sacamos manoplas y botellas sí, y ese día.
Ya merito te quitaba la máscara yo, bro.
Así es, invitamos a todos. You know, we invite everybody from the RGV for that, the 29th. CC's promotions with, you know, the festival that she's bringing with Grupo Duelo, Intenso Control, Pirata Morgan, big wrestlers. It's gonna be a great event, Rock.
Y lo bueno es que los luchadores se prestan con la gente y toman fotos y todo eso, ¿verdad?
Así es correcto.
Y llevan máscaras y llevan de todo, ¿verdad?
They take their stuff, they sell their stuff, their merchandise, you know.
Hablando de máscaras, enséñame las máscaras que traíste porque tú tienes una historia, le has luchado a muchos mascarados y le has quitado la máscara a varios.
Fíjate, Rock, esta máscara es una de las máscaras que this is besides the audience that we had. Back when we started promoting Lucha Libre here in the Valley in the 90s, we had a show. I had a show with La Super Parca, you know, Tour His Mask. I don't know if you can see it.
Is that the one that died?
No, that's not the one that died. There's three Parcas, you know.
Okay.
Which is now Elia Park was the first one, which is he was the original La Parca, the guy that wrestled for WCW.
And he passed away?
No, not him. Okay. He's the original Parca. Right now, I think he changed his name to Elia Park. He's one probably the best wrestler right now in Mexico. You know, so this is from his sobrino. Son familiares, you know.
Out of all the wrestlers, bro, on WCW, I think La Parca was the one that won the fans over more than any other one.
I think La Parca was the one that you know, had the best fans, you know.
The chairman of the board, and he came out with a chair.
Everybody liked him.
Well, he had that dance, and just with that one little dance, like, he won everybody over.
He had everybody going, man.
And then the whole suit that's like a skeleton, bro. Está bruto.
Exactly. La Muerte.
I also have this little mascara, you know, that, I don't know, I remember one of his matches, you know, I started wrestling, y se metió máscara sagrada, and I tore his mask up, you know.
Is that the big guy or the little guy?
Yeah, this is the big guy.
Oh, Porque el chiquito está bruto, bro. Saca la madre.
Yeah, that was many years ago. You're talking about 15, 20 years ago.
Mm. Well, even the big one was not even that tall, right? Was he like 5'8"?
Yeah, no. The big one, he was probably like 6'1", 6'.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because I know his son's like 6'2", or something like that.
Máscara sagrada, bro. That's a badass.
And then, yeah, this guy, you know, everybody saw him. He's probably been the best meanie the world has ever had, which was Mascarita Sagrada, then Mascarita Dorada. Then he went to WWE. Which was El Torito, you know.
Uh-huh.
A big shout out to my friend, man. He's a good friend of mine.
Yeah.
So this is Torito from...
Está bruta la máscara esa, bro.
From WWE. I mean, I have a big collection of masks, you know, that I would want to share. But yeah, you know, we have time. So
How was it growing up with your dad being involved in wrestling? Because tu jefe era wrestler también, ¿verdad?
My dad started wrestling in the 70s. You know, he started in... he trained in Reynosa. Then he started wrestling in Matamoros. And then he went back to Reynosa. He started wrestling as El Diabolic, okay? Mm-hmm. Then he changed his name to Ku Klux Klan, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
He came out with the Ku Klux Klan, you know. Obviously, he didn't throw tortillas back then. You know, it was something that I did. Then I started naming myself Ku Klux Spawn, El Hijo de Ku Klux Klan, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So my dad, that's how he wrestled in Reynosa as Ku Klux Klan.
Was he hated over there, bro?
When he debuted, he was technical. He was a good guy. El Diabolic. He was pretty good. He was very acrobatic. Then after, he started gaining weight and stuff like that. You know, he had his regular, you know, he was a printer. He had a print shop for many years. From there, he started wrestling at nights. You know, during the day, he'd do his job. And at nights, he would go wrestle. He wrestled at Ku Klux Klan. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. He was very hated. Yeah, he was a very hated character. Nobody.
Your dad.
Well, hold on. When you were real little, did you think it was real? Or were you scared? Or you were in on the whole thing?
I'm gonna tell you something. Wrestling is real, bro. Mm-hmm. I mean, people think, oh, it's fake, this and that. You know, los chingazos son de verdad.
That's hurt. Look at La Parca. He died in the ring.
I mean, I've had injuries, bro. I've broken my hand. I've broken my both ankles. I mean, it's La Parca died, bro. The guy after se avienta el tope. I remember a day, I have a friend of mine, you know, he's a local wrestler, very good. His name's Asterisco Jr. He wrestled with him, La Parca, in Reynosa. Then that evening, I think in Monterrey, you know, he had to wrestle again. And that's when, you know, he flew off the ring, he landed wrong. And that, you know, shit went from there, bro.
But did your father smarten you up so you would be calm and, you know that he was okay? Or did you just kind of...
No. I mean, he came hurt, you know, mm-hmm. He broke bones too, you know. People say, ah, es mentira. No, I mean, like I said, los golpes son de veras. I mean, and you got to train. That's why you train to, so you can, it's like a boxer. You got to train to know how to fight, how to fall, you know, stuff like that.
Yeah.
And you can just tell this guy right here, tell me los chingazos no te dolieron cuando te los metimos.
Pues estaban a toda madre, bro. A mí me gustaron.
You were into it.
¿Te quieres más? A mí hace lo que quieres.
No, porque me gusta dar chingazos también. ¿Entiendes? A golpear y tú sabes y...
¿A poco golpeas a tu esposa?
No, ella me golpea a mí. ¡Ay,
chinga, cabrón!
Ella me golpea a mí.
Exactamente.
Ya, y le pido que me golpee, ¿entiendes?
You asked for the spanking.
Le canto la song de Boy George la que te gusta T-Spawn. Do you really want to hurt me?
I mean, it's an enter... It's like WWE. It's an entertainment show, bro. Lucha Libre is the same way. It's an entertainment show.
But you know what I noticed about Lucha Libre, bro, is like I never see promos. Like I in the WWE, the American Wrestling, you know, federations, you see the promos that build up the fight.
The marketing is very different.
Over here
from Mexico and you know,
yeah, but over here all of a sudden you just see wrestlers wrestle against each other. There's really no reason or rhyme or nothing. It's just to wrestle and
no hype.
There's no hype. There's no storyline. Is there storylines?
Yes, there is. There is storylines. You know, there are storylines, you know, when lo hacen máscara contra máscara, you know.
Because what we had was a storyline.
That's a storyline.
We hyped it up. That's we did promos. We did it on radio, but I don't see that a lot done, even by local independent wrestlers.
No, you don't. They don't have the we don't do the marketing. You know, Mexico doesn't do the marketing like the way we do it here in the United States.
You know, now with YouTube and social media and cameras, look at what we're doing here. You could set up cameras and have a weekly or monthly show on a YouTube channel called Lucha Linas, Lucha Libre.
That is correct. You can do that. I mean, you know, with the amount of matches I do a year, I could probably do that.
You know, I don't know if you ever saw that, Spawn, but the NWA, which is now owned by Billy Corgan, he was putting it on YouTube.
That is correct.
And it was the smartest thing he ever did, because now the NWA, now they're on Fight TV. Everybody recognized it. So the concept is right here on YouTube.
That would be awesome for something like that to happen down here in the Valley, bro.
Yeah.
Would you consider that?
That's a good idea. Yep.
No manita, los sponsors, dad.
Pues ahí los tenemos, dad.
Roadies.
Roadies fried chicken.
Sponsoring
Dr. T.
And that finishing move was brought to you by Roadie's Country Fried Chicken.
The Oriental Gizzard.
Yeah. So, ¿y qué es lo que ha hecho, man? You've been retired? You said you retired?
Yeah, I've been retired for 2 years, man. You know, I think the last time I went up in the ring was 2 years ago with some partners of mine from Three Bats from Brownsville, Texas. But I'm just retired, man. Just living the vida loca.
See? Are you managing, like, at the show that's going to be happening in May? Will you manage anybody?
No, I'm a promoter, man. I promote the show. I've been promoting Lucha Libre since I was 21. So, to right now, I continue doing shows, local shows, at least once a month. I'm at Los Portales in Alton on 6 Mile in Conway.
It's in Alton. Is that a restaurant or something?
No, that's a flea market. Before I was
like 3 Mile Line, isn't it?
No, that's four.
4 Mile Line.
Yeah, I'm not at the four. I'm at the 6 Mile.
So there's another one up ahead.
He's at the classy one. Let's get it straight, Rock.
Yeah, I'm at the classy
Come
one.
Come on, dude. He's not at that other one. Get the facts straight.
You got that clear, right?
Oye, y cuando estaba watchando WCW, I know Psicosis and Rey Mysterio, they were masked. And then they did a gimmick where they took their masks off.
Yeah,
bro.
I remember it was.
What were your thoughts on that?
I thought that was crazy when Kevin Nash took Rey Mysterio's mask off, and then he put it back on, and people just, you know, I mean, it is what it is, man. Money talks, I guess.
And then he put it back on, and it's like he never took it off, and it's just like, I mean, I think he was treading on some area in an area where not many luchadores tread.
Yeah, and Psicosis actually, he never. There's been two or three Psicosis, you know. I know the two good ones, which was Nicho. Nicho's the original from Tijuana. He's the one that lost the mask. He was the first one that went to WWE, which was WCW. And then, you know, it was a fight between empresas, you know. One of the owners of a wrestling company in Mexico owned the copyrights or something like that. So that was the purpose why the other one took his mask, you know, the name off and stuff like that. So... he called himself Nicho El Millonario, which was Psicosis, the original guy.
Well, you had speaking of copyright, you had some issues with using the name Spawn.
Yeah, I got
Did they contact you, or who contacted you about that? Talk into the mic so we can hear
they,
you.
They did call me up, and that's the reason why I said, hey, my name's El Spawn. You
who
know?
Called you up?
I got some mail through mail.
Was it like a lawyer?
Yeah, a lawyer.
And it's like cease and desist.
Yeah, I took care of it. You know, no problem.
On behalf of what company or what was it? Disney Marvel Comics
something
or
like that. I don't remember.
And it, so it was, I mean, because I always wondered about like the Hulk, Hulk Hogan, how he had that. You know, what is it? That's a Marvel character.
Yeah, yeah.
And
but I had my name registered as El Spawn, so it was okay.
All you needed to do is add that little L, and that's it. Taken care of.
Yeah, but I took care of it since I debuted in 1998. I debuted in 1997. 1998, I had my name registered. Races.
Rock, you could be El John Cena. Yep. And then you're taken care of.
No, it'll be Juan.
Juan Cena.
El Juan Cena.
Siempre Cena.
Porque cenas.
A las 7 de la noche.
Juan Traga. No cenas.
Tragas. Yeah.
So, ya no vas a luchar tú, nomás vas a estar haciendo...
Yeah, I mean, I think this show has inspired me a little bit, man, that we might do the Rock versus Spawn 5, bro.
Pues, esta vez te voy a meter una chinga, Spawn.
Pelas, güey, lo que haces.
No, güey, no, las nalgas, güey. Las nalgas.
And the winner gets the loser's 401k.
Yeah.
No, chingado, lo malo es de ahí donde te platiqué. Está hasta el tronco el banco.
Sí. Oye, no, the winner gets the other guy's social security check for 4 months.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It wouldn't be a bad idea, no?
Yeah.
Rock versus Spawn 5.
Oye, bro, going back to your dad, he ended up in a wheelchair, bro.
Yeah, my dad, after many years, you know, he got sick, diabetic. You know, he was como todos los mexicanos, you know, cabezones, you know, he wouldn't take his medication and stuff like that, uh-huh. You know, had complications, you know, after 15, 16 years, you know, he died at a very, very young age, man.
And he had his legs amputated.
That's
both, yep, of them.
Yes, he did.
And he was in a wheelchair, and he'd be there at the wrestling matches, folks. And one time, the Rudos just like, they picked up the chair and threw him off the chair and everything, dude. It looked really serious, bro.
Yeah, man. My dad, he lost one of his foot first, you know. Then, ever one event, you know, we were here at Aragon, which is Tejano, whatever, and Pierrot, el hijo de Pierrot, was fighting and against La Super Parca, and you know, Pierrot was upset because my dad was in the middle. A mi papá le encantaba el pedo, you know what I mean? Sí. So he was down there by the ring. So el hijo de Pierrot, you know, just grabbed his leg, you know, took it off his prosthesis.
He had prosthesis.
Prosthetic.
So, yeah.
He took off the prosthetic?
Yeah, it took out his leg.
Started hitting him.
Why are you hitting yourself?
Yeah, you know, and I actually felt bad because I had done it already myself too, bro.
As a rudo?
Yeah, in a show.
But your dad was doing it for the business, for the entertainment.
For the business, man. So,
but it's pretty bad, dude, like to see that.
Yeah, so no. My dad was actually the one that inspired me, man. Hey, métete a la lucha, no, you know. No te va a dejar dinero, pero te va a dejar muchas amistades, man. I mean, yeah. I have a full-time job, so it's real hard that, you know, wrestle and have a full-time job. So that's also one of the reasons why, you know, también, yeah, I said, you know what, it's that the young people, you know, I'm all for that, man. Let the young people, you know, come up and do what they, you know.
Wrestling doesn't pay much, bro.
Nope, wrestling doesn't pay much unless you go professional. Unless you go professional and you do that for a living, you know, you start making some serious money, man. I mean, I want to tell you something. Wrestlers, you know, they make money, man. Professional wrestlers, they make money. So that's one of the reasons why, you know, in my events, you know, I got to charge 25, 15, 20 bucks. You know, I can't be charging 10 bucks, 8 bucks, you know, like before. You know, those were my prices 20 years ago, you know, at the Pulga, mm-hmm, or at Aragon, you know what I mean? Charging 10 bucks for adults, 5 for kids, man. There's no way you can do that now, you know. As you see my programs that I bring down, I got to charge at least $25-$30 a person, you know, to make it. Because, man, these guys, you know, they make some serious money, man.
And then they put their bodies on the line, man.
That,
you know,
that's right.
It's a lot of work. And, you know, you see these national TV shows, you know, wrestling shows, and they've got padding all around. You know, you go to a Mexican Lucha Libre show, and there's like cement and stuff. I mean,
Well, let me tell you something, man. I have probably one of the best rings in the valley. So I mean, my ring's pretty legit.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a
yeah, but around on the floor, it's old school. Like, oh, yeah, back in the old
right,
days.
Right now, it's still old school, man.
Yeah.
Anywhere you go here in the valley, Mexico, it's all Tierra Caliche, cemento, you know, you name it, you know. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's different from what you see on TV, you know, WWE with the padding around it and stuff like that.
What injury do you have still that you live with that it's just like chingao?
Well, my MCL, my meniscus, mm-hmm, you know, 2 torn meniscus on my right leg, man, that I haven't actually had surgery on.
Well, you know, the video that I put earlier when you guys se montonaron conmigo, ¿verdad? At the end, they throw you against a corner, and there's a table, and you flip, and you fall with it, like, back. And
chingao, man, that thing hurt, man. Hurt for a couple of days. Yeah, it was a pretty good hit.
Hey.
So that's what I'm telling people, you know, wrestling's for real. Like, people, yeah, it's great, there's storylines, but you know what? Los chingazos son de veras.
Oye, y lo bueno es que tú te metiste en el Salinas promotion, that, so your dad stepped aside, you started, I'm going to continue doing shows, I already know how to do it, I'm going to take care of the guys.
My dad stepped aside, you know, when he started getting sick, and back then I used to wrestle a lot in Reynosa, so I started getting all these contacts from wrestlers, and I just said, hey, you know, you guys are coming Tuesday nights here, I'm, you know, I'll start doing shows Wednesdays. So I still have a partner, my compadre from a promoter from Reynosa, you know, which he does shows every Sunday. You know, we started doing shows here together on Wednesday night, bringing Triple A. You know, we would bring Triple A shows here to Tejano Saloon. You know, that's where I met El Hijo del Perro Guayo, Pierrot, you know, everybody. I mean, you name it. You know, I've brought old school wrestlers. I've probably fought every single old school wrestler, Mil Máscaras, El Santo, Tinieblas, Blue Demon, La Parca. I mean, you name it, bunch of Gato Volador, you know, but I'm talking about, you know, famous wrestlers, you know, throughout Mexico, Pirata Morgan, Pierrot, El Hijo de Pierrot, Máscara Sagrada. You name it.
Oye, y Héctor Garza todavía está luchando ese vato, ¿no?
Héctor Garza passed away, Rock. Many, sí. I don't know. I think
ese vato tenía un move que se aventaba como tornillo, se dije al tornillo, algo así.
I believe 10 years ago, I was barely talking to one of my friends, you know, because I said, hey, man, I'm going to be at the Rock called me. And the guy said, what? Rock Johnson? Like
the Dwayne The Rock?
Dwayne The Rock? And I'm like, no, dude, The Rock, rock and roll from...
Sí, because Dwayne Johnson no trae nada. Se va
so, a... so we started talking about...
Hablen conmigo mejor.
Dwayne Johnson doesn't know Ramon Ayala.
No, we started talking no about... we started talking about Héctor Garza, man. I said, man, it was a pleasure, you know, of wrestling him. He has a family member right now. He's one of the biggest stars right now in WWE. His name's Angel Garza. Angel Garza. I don't know if you've seen him, Rock.
¿Y qué es hermano de él?
Es sobrino. Sobrino. I think it's sobrino. You know, he was called El Hijo del Ninja, from Multimedios. He was at some, you know, program in Mexico. Became a wrestler, and he joined WWE, man. And he's one of he's a big star right now for WWE wrestling Monday night. He wrestled.
He had a gimmick. He was on NXT, I think.
He was an NXT.
Yeah, and he had a gimmick where he would like kiss a girl.
Okay,
would...
Now he has a gimmick of he puts a rose in his mouth, and I guess he gives it to somebody or something like that.
Y el ¿cómo se llama el psicodélico? Ese era algo de
psicodélico. Yeah,
he was a relative.
We brought him so many times. You know, I took him to. I promoted him here in the valley.
But he was related to somebody.
He was related to Alberto El Rio, Mil Máscaras.
Yeah, there you go.
Dos Caras, you know. He's from San Antonio, Texas. I think he's retired already.
¿Y qué dice aquel Alberto El Patrón, Mato? You know,
he was getting in trouble with
the law and shit, right?
Yeah, I really don't know much. He was here recently with another friend of mine. He did a promotion last week or the week before.
I am Brownsville.
No. He did it here in El Fuego.
Órale.
And he brought him down. You know, he had a sold-out crowd as well. He was here. I think.
¿Qué tanto cobra ese vato para venir?
Man, I have no idea, man. I guess people say. I personally haven't brought him to the valley. I took him one time to Reynosa. I made a friend of mine a favor. He had a show over there, so I took him over. He got here, took him over. I think he ranges maybe, I don't know, close 5 to 10 a match. Uh-huh.
He's gonna have a match here at the Payne Arena. Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw that. July 31st. I think July 31st. There's an event.
See, I went to the last one they had there at Payne Arena, and it was a lot of fun, man. It was awesome. Yeah. Well, yeah, I also wanted to talk to you about, because I think you're the only promoter and wrestler that has put an event together, and it was the very first time you put an event in downtown McAllen. It was like a venue that's basically known for English-style wrestling, you know, Wrestling Revolution, TWL. And you did a show there for the very first time, and it attracted a SWAT team. They were on top of the roof. And apparently, there was some cartel-based thing going on with the wrestling going on there. And it was all over the place. And with social media, man, todos estaban like, oye, ¿qué está pasando downtown? Y era tu evento.
Yeah, that was one of my events.
And that they had the SWAT, ATF, and DEA, they were all over.
Yeah,
on top.
They were. I guess they were looking for somebody that apparently was there that he wrestled. But, man, You know, they did a whole raid, you know, investigators, well, FBI. Well,
apparently something.
DEI, something happened.
Yeah, there was like some cartel guy that does moonlights as a wrestler or something like that.
Yeah, something like that. I really don't know much of the information.
Well, what did they tell you when
they didn't tell me anything. They were like, who are you? I'm the promoter. Okay, bye. We're not looking for you. Basically, that's what they told me.
Okay, so they didn't give you any information.
Oh, no, they didn't give me any information. Nothing happened.
And you didn't want to pick on it, man, because they'll kick your ass, too.
So basically, they did the investigation, and I guess, you know, it failed. You know, I don't think they were looking for what they had, you know, been wanting to look for.
But that was on a Sunday afternoon, dude.
That was on a Sunday. It was
all over the news, and then the social media blew up.
Social media for I don't know.
And supposedly 3 weeks. A wrestler that wrestles with a mask is also, you know, one of the top guys in cartel. And it was...
That's a great gimmick. Dije, ya vienen por mí.
Oye, you could have built up on that, dude, and really, like, you know, be notorious and, you know, and it would have attracted. I think you could have marketed it.
I think people, you know, fans got a little scared after, you know, my next show, because I continued doing shows. I started doing shows at Cine Rey for I don't know, it was, 10 years ago?
Uh-huh.
You know, and then, you know, others came aboard and stuff like that. You know, but after that, I continued doing shows, and I started seeing the attendance go down. And then, you know, I asked the owners, hey, what's going on? And said, man, people probably got scared. And I said, yeah, you're probably right. So I left the venue. I started going to other venues, and people started following me. But, yeah, it was scary. You know, it was scary because there was a lot of kids in there, man.
Mm-hmm.
And
there were,
you know,
SWAT teams with guns. And
yeah, everybody, you know, came in with weapons and stuff like, you know, SWAT team. What was it? I think FBI or
DEA, FBI.
Like
and yeah.
So that was it, man. So
and how long ago was that? That was like,
man, chingado, that was in
2012 or 13.
What I,
bro? It was what after I. It was after our amazing match at Tejano Saloon.
Yeah,
dude.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
A few years later.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, El Spawn with us here on the Rockin' Chaz Show, and you were the perfect person to have here on Cinco de Mayo, bro. I mean, perfecto.
Thank you, sir.
Y pues, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Okay? And also, we have the Rockin' Chaz Random Album! Órale! So, la semana pasada, Rob Hahn, he pulled out that Merle Haggard record. Spawn, tienes que venir para acá y sin ver, tienes que sacar un disco de aquí a ver cuál es el Random Album que va a sacar el Spawn. Nomás no te me arrimes mucho, carnal, porque te meto un chingazo o algo y no quiero que se vaya a hacer un desmadre aquí en el... Y las tortillas aquí las tenemos. ¡Ahora el Spawn!
No, no. Oh,
¡ay, eso!
¡Stop! Charlie.
What was that?
Charlie, hold on.
Slap me.
I'm going to have to take my chanclas off right now.
Careful.
Bring it up.
Careful with the bobbleheads.
Hey, that sounded real, didn't it? No puedes ver, güey. Oh, acha. Al alba, bro. Diary of a Madman. Ozzy Osbourne.
That's fun.
Perfecto con el Spawn. Ah, bueno, se move. Spawn.
Careful.
I should have been ready and sold it, man. La cagué. Bueno, me dijiste ese jale.
We'll have to look for Rock's molars. His incisors.
It sounded pretty hard.
Because he slapped his chest when
his
he did
canines.
It.
I didn't even know that.
I know.
Wow.
It looks real. Es como cuando avientan una patada y se dan una cachetada en la pierna. Y se oye como, good stuff.
Well, I mean, he's a pro.
Professional. Ladies and gentlemen, El Spawn! Yeah. Pasen buena noche. Mañana nos vemos con Isabel María. Isabel Marie, she's a singer with the Q Productions. So we're going to have her tomorrow night. Todos, digan, Goodbye.
Saludos.